It is a sobering thing when I had to face that the entire project of church planting and starting a church and starting a Christian school was ultimately my using people. It had nothing to do with the glory of God. It had everything to do with an insecure, shameful young man who was trying to validate himself through ministry success. So people who worked for me who were highly competent got stroked and praised, and people who didn't come through got disdained. And there was a constant fight in our staff between whether Ray was the best boss to work for you ever had or whether he was a jerk. Because half the staff got nothing but love and the other half got my anger. Because the bottom line is the whole project had to do with me. And finally, this counselor showed me that I was safe, that I had the righteousness of Christ. I was simul justus et peccator. I was at the same time just and a sinner. I was thoroughly rotten and yet thoroughly loved and treasured and adored, that I had righteousness. Romans chapter 1 was true. There is a righteousness that comes from God. The Christian life isn't producing righteousness and then offering it up to God in hopes that you'll be found favorable, but it's God producing a righteousness and giving it to us and never taking it away. And I began to slowly rest in the righteousness of Jesus, and I began to believe that I was a beloved son. And getting the gospel began to impact my marriage and my preaching and my parenting and my leadership and my friendship. Somebody asked Pete, I think earlier, you know, how did you go from sort of not getting it to getting it, and how did you, well, you know, I pretty much say, honestly, whatever gospel comprehension I've gained every day leaks out while I sleep. So every morning when my feet hit the floor, I move out into the world to validate myself. The old ruts of self-validation and producing my own righteousness runs so deep that I truly have to repent of that and return to the gospel, you know, throughout the day.
Because I can look back and say, as a man truly who loved Jesus, as a man who had no doubt about Jesus dying in my place upon the cross, about his even covering me with his righteousness by faith, but a man so conflicted on the inside, I needed to see what Jonah finally began to understand. That I'm a clinging man. That I grab for things to try to make life work for me. Because that gospel was not enough for so many years. Convinced intellectually, but living out of my head, having no clue about what it means to live out of my heart.